In 2011, a German mobile communications scientist, Harold Haas, did a 10x global talk in University of Edinburgh. He demonstrated transfer of data at high speeds over visible light. This was probably the first time the world had witnessed data being transferred from a light bulb. Wireless communication has become a very common entity of our daily experience. It is so common that you don't even think about it in your day-to-day life. From the TV in your bedroom to the smartphone in your palm, everything communicates wirelessly nowadays. With this massive usage of wireless communication, scientists are always looking for ways to make communication faster, more convenient, and efficient. The most common interaction that people have with wireless communication is the Wi-Fi at their home. A Wi-Fi simply allows data to be transferred wirelessly, and to enable that, you have to set up a Wi-Fi router. But what if I tell you that you can connect to internet via the lights coming out from a light bulb? Yes, it is possible, and it even has a name, Li-Fi. So, what is Li-Fi exactly? The term Li-Fi or light fidelity was coined by Harold Haas himself. Li-Fi is a wireless communication technology which utilizes light to transmit data among computing devices. In terms of its end user, the technology is very similar to Wi-Fi. The key technical difference being that Wi-Fi uses radio frequency to induce a voltage in an antenna to transmit data, whereas Li-Fi uses the modulation of light intensity to transmit the same. This allows Li-Fi to even function in areas which are susceptible to electromagnetic interference, like aircraft cabins, hospitals, or military facilities. Researchers have reached data rates of over 224 gigabytes per second, which is much faster than typical fast broadband. Once the technology is fully ready for public use, Li-Fi is expected to be 10 times cheaper than Wi-Fi. Okay, we know what Li-Fi is, but how does it work? Li-Fi is basically a derivative of optical wireless communications technology, OWC, which uses the light from LEDs to send data to a device, such as a laptop or tablet. The device has a receiver to pick up light signals, and a transmitter to send light signals back to the lamp using infrared light. The core technology underneath Li-Fi is called visible light communications, VLC. In VLC, the light from the LED lamps changes intensity billions of times a second, faster than a human eye's ability to detect. This change in intensity becomes a digital signal, which can carry information from the internet to a user and back again. Multiple lights can be added to a single network, so that you can move around from light to light without losing your connection. You don't have to be directly under a lamp to use Li-Fi. The digital signal is also carried by light reflected off walls and other surfaces. A Li-Fi network still needs a regular internet service provider to supply internet to a home or office via wires. Li-Fi can then be deployed within a home or office to provide a wireless internet connection to devices. But why do we need Li-Fi in the first place? Number 1. Spectrum crunch. Current Wi-Fi technology already uses light traveling along fiber optic cables. Yet the last piece of wireless network connectivity into our home or office are still primarily delivered via radio waves. As more and more devices connect to the internet, the space for radio frequencies is becoming oversaturated. This is known as spectrum crunch. In the near future, there may not be enough wireless bandwidth to support growing consumer demand. By using light for these last few meters of connectivity, Li-Fi opens 1,000 times more bandwidth than using radio waves alone. Number 2. Faster speed. Li-Fi offers much faster speeds compared to traditional Wi-Fi. Companies that tested Li-Fi projected it to be up to 1,000 times faster than Wi-Fi. It can transmit 224 gigabytes of data per second. If you need to download a high-definition video or send large files online, you can do it in a matter of seconds. Number 3. Data security. Li-Fi is considered much safe with respect to data security. Visible light is much difficult to intercept compared to radio waves, as it cannot pass through walls. So when you use Li-Fi in an enclosed room, you can ensure your connection is secure. If you run a business that deals with sensitive data, or simply want to boost your security online, you can use Li-Fi for your vulnerable devices. Number 4. Sustainability. With Li-Fi, you save a lot of energy, which otherwise would go into running Wi-Fi routers. As Li-Fi makes use of same light bulbs, which is also used for illumination, there is no extra energy used. That efficiency can help your household save on energy costs, especially if you use routers and signal boosters all day long. Plus, when you leave a room, switching the light off means turning off the Li-Fi as well. The history of visible light communication, VLC, which is the background technology behind Li-Fi, dates to 1880s. This was the time when first use of the visible light portion of the electromagnetic spectrum to transmit information was theorized. However, it was not until 2010 that some serious work went into making this theory a reality. Between January 2010 to January 2012, Harold Haas, the German professor whom we talked about earlier, started arranging funds for his VLC research project. Finally, with all the necessary funding, he started Project D-Light in January 2012 at Edinburgh's Institute for Digital Communications. Around the same time, Harold started his company Pure VLC, which was later renamed to Pure Li-Fi. In October 2011, a research organization, Fraunhofer IPMS, and many other VLC companies formed the Li-Fi Consortium. The purpose of this consortium was to promote high-speed optical wireless systems and to exploit visible light to overcome the limited amount of radio-based wireless spectrum available. Apparently, there were a lot of other independent players who also started working in development of this technology. In 2012, VLC technology was first exhibited using Li-Fi. By August 2013, data rates of about 1.6 gigabytes per second were demonstrated over a single color LED. In September 2013, a press release said that Li-Fi, or VLC systems in general, do not absolutely require line-of-sight conditions, which means Li-Fi will even work when there's a wall in between the transmitter and receiver. In October 2013, it was reported some Chinese manufacturers were also working on their own version of Li-Fi development kits. In April 2014, a Russian company, Stinz-Komen, announced the development of a Li-Fi wireless local network called Beamcaster. Their current module transfers data at 1.25 gigabytes per second, but they foresee boosting speeds up to 5 gigabytes per second soon. In 2014, a new record was established by Sisoft, a Mexican company, that was able to transfer data at speeds of up to 10 gigabytes per second across a light spectrum emitted by LED lamps. In July 2015, IEEE operated the APD in Geiger mode as a single photon avalanche diode, SPAD, to increase the efficiency of energy usage, which made the receiver even more sensitive. This operation was successful because of quantum-limited sensitivity that allowed receivers to detect weak signals even from a far distance. In June 2018, Li-Fi passed a test at a BMW plant in Munich, Germany. This test was done to check operating performance of Li-Fi in industrial environment. In August 2018, Kyle Academy, a secondary school in Scotland, had pilot the use of Li-Fi within the school. students were able to receive data through a connection between their laptops and a USB device. USB device had a receiver which was able to translate the rapid on-off light from the ceiling LEDs into data. In June 2019, French company OLEDCOM tested their Li-Fi technology at the 2019 Paris Air Show. So you see that there's a lot of work going on in development of Li-Fi. The first commercially available Li-Fi system was presented at the 2014 Mobile World Congress in Barcelona. Back then, Li-Fi market was projected to have a compound annual growth rate of 82% from 2013 to 2018, and to be worth over $6 billion per year by 2018. However, the market has not developed as such, and Li-Fi remains within a niche market. But why? Even though Li-Fi seems to be a very cool tech, but like any new technology, it is yet to mature for public usage. All the content on internet only sing praises of how good Li-Fi is. But there are still a lot of issues, which researchers are trying to solve for making Li-Fi consumer ready. Let's have a look into these issues, one by one. Number 1. Need of a new special hardware. Li-Fi needs special LED bulbs for transmission and photodetector for reception. The need for special LED bulbs has made it difficult to implement Li-Fi on a large scale, as these bulbs are not yet mass-produced. Number 2. Uplink issues. Every Li-Fi presentation has always missed out a major part of its implementation, the uplink. There isn't any technology available for mobile devices to transmit Li-Fi signals. When both uplink and downlink are present in Li-Fi, there are possibilities of them interfering with each other, resulting in corruption of transmitted data. Number 3. Limited range. Li-Fi is developed with an intention to replace the traditional Wi-Fi systems by allowing increase in bandwidth. But one major problem with Li-Fi lies within its basic principle of using light for transmission, which limits the range of Li-Fi. A common household can get along with a single Wi-Fi router, whereas the same household would need multiple Li-Fi bulbs for covering the whole house. Number 4. Competition from Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is an existing technology, while Li-Fi is a work in progress. Wi-Fi is being used everywhere for wireless communication. All devices are already designed and configured to work with Wi-Fi. For Li-Fi to replace Wi-Fi, it needs to convince consumers that it is indeed much better than Wi-Fi. Number 5. Light interference. Although Li-Fi LEDs would have to be kept on for transmitting data, they could be dimmed to below human visibility, while still emitting enough light to carry data. This is also a major bottleneck of the technology when based on the visible spectrum, as it is restricted to the illumination purpose. It's not ideally adjusted to a mobile communication purpose, given that other sources of light, for example the sun, will interfere with the signal. There is no doubt that Li-Fi has great potential, and the idea of internet from light bulbs sounds very fun, but in reality, there are a lot of challenges which are yet to be resolved. A wide use of Li-Fi may never become a reality, because we already have a way cheaper option in the form of Wi-Fi. Also, the spectrum unavailability is not that a big issue in the first place for end-user internet consumption yet. However, there are still a lot of specific use cases where Li-Fi may be the best option, like underwater wireless communication, internet usage inside an aircraft, Internet of Things, IoT, etc., where radio spectrum has not been able to solve the purpose. But you never know what future holds. If you enjoyed our content and want to see more, do like this video and subscribe to Qreus.